I'm gonna put a trigger warning on this poem. It's called Assault, so. My body is its own empire. Yet somehow you are still the king, because you took this body by force, and I am still blinded from ways to be rid of you, even though you have not sat in your throne since the day you took me, as if I am some kind of trophy you won for a sport you never enjoyed playing, so you hid me away to rust in your closet, so I would no longer be the inconvenience in your conversations, as you wonder why your friends still ask you questions about what happened between us when it happened so long ago. I wonder if the guitarist in your band knows that every time he likes one of my photos on Instagram, it's like he's wrapping the strings from his instrument around my neck as I slowly lose the ability to inhale and exhale properly, plucking the feathers of my anxiety ready to burst. I heard that one of my childhood friends is now your roommate. I wonder if he thinks of me while you clink your shot glasses together and cheers to positive thinking and a healthy future before the liquor touches his lips and I slip away into memory once again. I used to hate the fact that I only ever wrote love poems. But now, sometimes there is nothing I miss more than only writing love poems, because now I trigger myself into always writing about you. But in a way, I feel like I have to, because there are still a lot of things I want people to know about you. Like how many times I said no to you. There are still a lot of things I want people to accept about you. Like how many times I said no to you. And there were 1,000 reasons why I didn't physically push you off of me. And I know that you knew that when this empire is outnumbered by someone stronger and bigger, eventually we would have to surrender, because you have told your friends that you remember me saying I don't want to do this, but eventually you thought you had consent, as if convincing someone to take part in intercourse is acceptable in the first place, as if my words slowly turning to silence was equivalent to me saying yes, take me, as if I wanted you to take me, as if I didn't want to be free anymore and wanted sleepless nights full of PTSD more. People say that sleep is for the weak, but I can't imagine a world where I am strong enough to close my eyes without the fear of seeing your face again, or hearing your voice again, or feeling your unwanted touch again. I don't know how you got in here when I double check that my doors and windows are locked every night, but you always seem to find a way in and bury yourself in my brain as if it is your favorite place to be. I have forgotten what it feels like to be free from unwanted kings who don't deserve a throne but feel like it belongs to them. No matter how badly they are unwanted, no matter how many times I condemn him, I want to know how it feels to be free again.